think as a young adult, I had everything going for me. I mean, I come from a family that is comfortable. I always wanted to be a social worker and I was doing social work. I was happy, but there was something deep down within me that told me I wasn't contented. I was searching for something more. So I took a gap year and I went to Thailand to work with women in prostitution together with the Good Shepherd Sisters. There was just something, the way the sisters related to the women, you know, the way the sisters looked at them, that really drew me to find out more, to just be curious. Many people think discernment is like one big decision you make for the rest of your life, but in my experience, it's just a door open and God invites. And my response is to say yes for this moment and this step. And God continues to lead and continues to open more doors.
It's the charism of this mission, Good Shepherd Mission, which expresses the merciful love of God through ministry, in community life, and in our prayer life.
It's very much linked to the scripture passage of Jesus the Good Shepherd, who would leave the 99 to look for that one lost sheep.
That love and compassionate mercy must have had, that really drew me. And I think that is really our mission. A lot of very vulnerable women and children that's wounded, very abused. It's really to bring them back in reconciliation to themselves, to those around them, to the Good Shepherd. Restore them to the dignity that was theirs in the first place.
When you read the parable of the Good Shepherd, God is always searching, finding, and rejoicing. Jesus says, "What joy there is in heaven among the angels when one repentant sinner comes back to God."
Our mother foundress, St. Mary Euphrasia, her motto is, one person is of more value, one person is of most precious of the whole world. And that really struck me, because that symbolizes the identity of my belovedness in the eyes of God. And the children whom I'm serving right now, they don't see themselves as the beloved. I remember this girl, she actually hid herself. Then she kept saying, "You go away, nobody like me." I held her very tightly. I just spent that time, you know, just allow her to express, just to be herself. She needed that space. But after that incident, from someone who didn't know how to say, "I am angry," now she could say that. And the song that she likes is, "Jesus loves me, yes I know." So one day when I was driving, she just looked up to the skies, you know. Then she pointed at one cloud. I said, sister, see. And she said, "Okay, you see, it's a heart shape, you know, it's a heart shape. Looks like Jesus' heart. Jesus really loved me." I said, "Yes, God loves you."
What's the difference between a social worker and a religious who are all ministering to abused women and children? And my answer to them is, it's easy to be a shepherd and really hard to be a good shepherd. To be a good shepherd, it means I must first be that vulnerable sheep. I must first experience and admit and go into that place within me where I felt abandoned and rejected and so naked and in need of the good shepherd. The experience of that gentleness and compassion of the good shepherd has moved my heart and transformed my life from a wounded sheep to a shepherdess who can choose to serve and to love the women and children we minister to. Our Mother Foundress says, it is love that changes hearts. It is God's love that changes our hearts.
Journey with these women and children, they keep on reminding me, this heart of mine is created in the image of God. This heart of mine is created to love. In a way, they taught me what love is about.
I think you have no idea how much it means when after a very, very long and hard day, you know, where I was secretly crying and one sister just come up to me and go, "You look a bit down today, are you okay? And how was the little girl that you told us to pray for?" And it always touches me that I'm not alone in ministry. That, you know, every time I go to ministry, it's a whole band of sisters with me in prayer and in spirit. And that really tells me how our community is really binded by this single-mindedness for the mission.
What is beautiful is that the changes made our community living more flexible. If I have to go out and do my work, I go and do it. I don't have to be worried, I must be back for my meal in time. No, I'm doing something that is my work, my mission.
Yeah, but of course, I don't think it's realistic to expect like it's happy every day. Of course, there are tensions and difficulties among us. Every time it's an invitation for me to ask myself what assumptions they are made about what she just said, or how have my own upbringing or my own woundedness caused me to look at what she said with coloured lens. So it's always for me to really go back in prayer and reconcile with myself, reconcile with God, and then go back to the sister again. And this way, I think that's what's a very concrete way of saying what it means to be the witness to the world.
I have received so much in life. This love is something that I can't contain. It propels me, it moves me to share this love, because God's love is not just for me alone, but to others as well.
Every day I ask, am I happy? Am I happy to make this choice? Even though I cry today, even though I feel very heartbroken, you know, I feel very rejected. The children say, I hate you. But I still say yes, because of the sense of fulfillment, and I know the fruit is waiting.
I have no regrets. I'm happy, I'm contented, and I feel truly fulfilled in the Psalm 138. I called you to be my own. I know that, I feel that in my vocation.
Dear friends, after sharing so much, what is your heart telling you right now? It might be a sense of fear, it might be a sense of excitement, knowing that there are people praying for you, journeying with you. What you need to do is open your heart. If there is a will, there must be a way. And God will never disappoint us. So come and see, and you will be surprised by the gift of God.